it to the Grand Prix final in the past two seasons, but he hopes this will be his breakthrough year.
Yeah, 2 years ago, Elvis pulled out, and I had a chance to go. But I was injured too, so I couldn't go. And last year, I didn't skate well in the Grand Prix series. And this year, I came second in Skate America, so I have a chance to go Grand Prix final. So I want to go, because I never been, and I want to compete with Pushchenko, Yagudin, Timothy, everybody.
And we'll return to the NHK Trophy in Japan after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Look back at the ladies' short program, which took place earlier in the week here in Japan. Angela Nikodinov of the U.S. started things off with a flawless skate that included this triple lunge double toe combination. Nikodinov set a standard that no one else could match. She has the lead heading into the free skate, followed by Yelena Lyashenko of Ukraine and Tatiana Malinina of Uzbekistan. Meanwhile, Fumie Suguri of Japan, a favorite going into the competition, struggled with the required jumps and finished all the way down in sixth place. However, Suguri, Lyashenko, Malinina, Nikodinov, and Yoshie Anda of Japan all have a chance to make it to the Grand Prix final when the ladies take the ice a little bit later in the show.
Number 7, representing Japan, Takeshi Honda.
For the men, it's Jeffrey Buttle. That's right, Jeffrey Buttle from Canada, who leads over Yamano Tamura at this point as the favorite coming in, takes the ice right now. And the leader after the short program, Takeshi Honda, the 20-year-old who now trains in Canada but back at home here in Japan. As Peter said earlier, not only looking to win the gold medal, to make a trip to the Grand Prix final, but also to go straight to the Olympics. Then his federation has told him if he makes the Grand Prix final lineup, he will not have to come back here and skate at the Japanese National Championships to make the Olympic team.
Two quads, 7 triples planned in this program. He opens with a triple flip, and he really got up into the air. Nice position, great landing. Here's the first of the two quads in the program, the quadruple toe loop. He needs this for his confidence. Whoa! Pitching forward, but he didn't bail out and fall. He's fighting for it.
Honda, the 4-time national champion of Japan, has had a chronic ankle injury, his right ankle, which affecting him earlier in the Grand Prix.
And right there, Quat Sal, knowing what he had done just before that on the toe loop, he corrected himself. Pretty good Quat Sal.
She picked up 9 points with his silver medal earlier in the season at Skate America. Very close to qualifying for the Grand Prix final, as is Todd Eldred sitting at home watching. He has 16 points overall right now.
Nice spread eagle right up into the triple axel. Oops, he was trying to do a triple toe loop after that, but he didn't feel comfortable, so he didn't take off.
Thank you.
did a good triple axel. Here's another one. No, single. It's called a pop. Take off the wrong part of the blade. You don't get the rotation you need. Too far back on his skate. Little mistakes like that that hurt him in performance. When he flips out of jumps, it breaks the continuity of the program. That's been his problem in the past, and he's trying to work through that.
It's from Fukushima, Japan, which is on the main island, about 2 hours from Tokyo. His dad is here in the arena watching him skate.
Not to just focus on the jumps. One of the things that makes Takeshi Honda a very good skater is the fact that he has nice carriage and posture as he skates. And he always holds that throughout his program. It's just these jumps that give him trouble.
You know, Jeffrey Buttle stood alongside the rink and watched that entire performance. Both he and Takeshi Honda train in Barrie, Ontario, Canada. He was watching this very closely.
Takeshi skates into this quadruple toe loop with a lot of speed. Good tight arms to get that rotation spinning, but when that upper body pitches forward, it's tough to stop the momentum as it moves down toward the ice. And then here is the quadruple salchow. Watch to see if there's a 2 foot landing. See if the left foot touches down, and right there it barely does. So not as strong as a 1 foot landing, but still no fall, so that's good.
Might not have been a performance of a lifetime, but you gotta believe that he did what he needed to do out there on the ice. Technical merit marks 5.4 up to 5.7.
Well, the thing that I'm really impressed with is the fact that he fought through those quads, and that was strong, and these scores are very good for him.
Now the presentation marks 5.5, all the way up to a 5.9 from the Japanese judge.
And the judge is certainly rewarding him for some of the things I talked about, carriage, line, posture, it's all there for Takeshi Honda.
Takeshi Honda from Japan firmly in the lead at this point ahead of Jeffrey Buttle of Canada.